When I started here over 7 years ago, our graduation rate was among the lowest of any large urban. We had the highest expulsions, suspensions, citations. We were the poster child for every poor demographic data point.
Teenagers right now go through so many things that maybe I didn't in my youth.
I was in a very dark place where I didn't want to go to school, I didn't want to make friends, I didn't want to do anything but just go home and go to sleep.
Especially being in a city like this where you go to high school and you have 3,200 kids on campus, right? You might feel alone and isolated, you might not be able to find your niche.
And it begins to harden them. It creates a mindset of hopelessness. And you can't get kids on a trajectory for prosperity and high levels of success if you don't have a nice, strong foundation around the health and wellness of who they are as people.
So today we'll discuss how much sugar is in our favorite drinks. It's really different when you see it physically compared to when you see it just on a label.
When we heard about this program with HealthCorps, it just made sense. Having a curriculum and the support structure that's necessary with a coordinator to lead not just the young people, but the entire community to a mindset around health.
Having a HealthCorps coordinator on our campus has had a really big impact. There's more awareness of well-being and self-care.
With Stephanie coming in the room, she's just like this huge toolbox of what I'm using already, more tools than I possibly knew I could use.
When Ms. Cox comes in to cover how to meditate, a lot of them have never even thought of meditation. And I've seen that they're engaged when she comes in and they actually participate.
What I've seen is a strong development of relationships with students to get them excited about health initiatives and then coordinate with the health career pathways. They're implementing cooking classes. They're coordinating with our gardening club.
Gardening for me definitely has a meditative side to it. It helps me calm down my brain and my thinking.
What really brought me to an interest in HealthCorps was the resiliency piece. The suicide rate is ridiculous now. And so having a place where they can get the tools to be able to deal with, address, manage those stresses is more critical than ever.
We've seen a drastic drop in the number of alerts we're seeing for self-harm or suicide ideation.
We're learning more and more about the struggles that our students have. If we cannot meet the mental health needs of our students, no academic goals are going to stick.
I think HealthCorps has got a very bright future because it's good politics and it's good policy. Kids need help. We're there to support them. Policymakers, stakeholders, civic leaders, principals, even the kids themselves recognize that we can play a role in bettering their lives.
We have seen some of our highest graduation rates at Sanji High School, where HealthCorps is active. Year after year after year, we've seen those indicators continue to improve and grow for our students.
I can't believe that more school districts aren't implementing this program. This just makes sense, and it's where we need to be, I think, as school districts, not just here in this region, but across the state and across the nation.
Bringing this on your campus will change the climate and culture in a positive way if everyone's able to get on board. I promise if you do it, you'll see a change on your entire campus.
I see my friends being a lot more positive and talking about mental health. I would have not continued to go to school if it wasn't for HealthCorps.
I'll see notes from the students that say that they feel happier, that they're more confident, that their self-esteem has increased, that they feel like they can make healthier decisions and that they can live a better life as a result of this program. And that's what makes it worth it.